So, sometimes, occasionally, when a content creator runs flat out of ideas on what to do on their channel, they might reach out to, you know, you guys maybe on Twitter and ask for questions to do like a Q&A video. It's very lazy, it's borderline not even content, but you know, when you're desperate, it might be something you'd think about doing. Q&A time! I haven't done one of these in maybe 2 years, and I'm sure you guys have some very serious burning questions you would like to ask me, and maybe you have asked them. And if this video turns out, to not be terrible, maybe I'll do another one. Make sure you follow me on Twitter because that's where I'll ask for more questions. Also, as of right now, I don't know when this video is even going up, but as of today, there's new designs on the website that has my shirts and stuff, and I feel really weird talking about this because I never mention merch. I've always had it, and it's always been there, but I mention it once in a blue moon. Hey, it says that you could support the channel that way if you wanted. So yeah, there's that. I'm gonna shut up and I'm gonna start reading questions. There is actually a pretty thought out one to begin with. Gary Smith asks if I can get my phone to flip it back around. No! What would you like in future as the next Nintendo console? Okay, this is almost an entire video on its own. Actually, I really like this question a lot because I do think about it a lot. I think they would have to continue with the hybrid theme at this point because the Wii U was obviously a complete failure and they've managed to make what is essentially a home console a huge success. No one expected the Switch to be as successful as it was. Even me and us, all of us that have been around this channel since the start of the whole Switch's lifespan that had a really good feeling about the Switch, but mostly just wanted to play the new Zeldas and Marios and didn't want to miss out. Like, I felt like it was going to be successful, but I didn't have any idea to this extent. So now, both their markets are in this hybrid system. If they went away from the hybrid system, they're going to have to then do portable and home console again, which means trying to get people invested in just like splitting people. It doesn't really make a lot of sense. Sticking with the hybrid theme. That's how I feel. Have you experienced Joy-Con drifting? I have not. My Joy-Cons are perfect. Sucks to be you. No. Loch Ness Monster says, do you still have a game collection in Australia or has everything been shipped over? You probably haven't seen the video, I'm guessing, where I actually showed my collection being ported over. I had it hanging at a friend's house for like 3 years. Thank you, Laura, and she helped me get it organized to get it all here, and it's actually behind you. There's a bunch of stuff in that closet right there, and there's like a whole room of junk over there. This is just what I could fit in here. It's actually not a big room. I did a room tour. That you should watch that. Frank the Cook, what do you cook? I'd love to know. What is your process of making a video, recording gameplay, writing the video, montage, brainstorming? Okay, so I've never been diagnosed with ADD or anything like that. My brother has it. So I wouldn't be surprised if I have some kind of attention deficit disorder because I cannot ever focus on any one thing for too long. And I feel like that is reflected so much in my channel because every video is like different. And I don't know if that helps me or hurts me. I know a lot of content creators like to try and stay in a lane and they just kind of make the content they make and you always know what to expect from that creator. And I would love to be like those creators. A shining example is Scott the Woz, an amazing human being.
Hey y'all.
But it would drive me insane to do the same thing every week. You know, you have your script, you have your structure, you have your skit, you have your review, and he does it perfectly. So it depends what video you're talking about as to my process because I like to tackle every video very different ways so I don't get bored week to week. So for example, if I was doing like a news video, a gaming news video, I actually love doing those because they're so quick and so fun. I usually wait until something is happening that I really care about and then I'll just stand here and I'll just blab and yell and whatever, and then in editing I'll just have fun with it, and typically that whole process is done in like 5 hours. It's almost like nothing. Make a thumbnail, clickbaity title, throw it up, I'm done. I love those. The eShop videos are by far the most intense videos I do on my channel. Because here's the process that goes into doing one of those videos. To start with most other videos, I can just play a game for a while and then review it. But those videos, I actually am proud of them. So I'll download all the games, I'll play all the games, and then I spend the entire day writing. Then I'll come up here, I'll set everything up, I'll stand here, I'll record. That typically takes anywhere between 1 hour and 2 hours. Then once that's done, I put it all on the computer and the editing takes an entire day if you like start early and finish late. Oh man, I can't tell you how much I'm loving having Vincent, who is actually editing this video, who has become a friend and a necessary part of this channel. Please don't go anywhere. How many games are in your collection currently? That actually got a lot of likes too. By the way, that was a JTG. I have no idea. Zine the says, before naming the channel Beatemups, what other ideas did you have for channel names? I don't know if I regret calling the channel Beatemups or not, because clearly to some extent it worked. I mean, here we are coming up on 700,000, if not already past it, whenever this video goes up. Thank you for that, by the way. But I've always hated the choice because I feel like it's restricting me from able to use my name in things, my channel name in things. I see like Scott the Woz. I don't know why he gets referenced twice here.
But Scott here.
When he makes a video, he gets to put his name at the end. If I did that, it would look weird. If I did 10 eShop games worth buying, Beatemups, it kind of looks like 10 eShop Beatemups worth buying. So I've always thought it was a really weird choice. You know, I made the channel like 6 years ago at this point. It was gonna be called Beatemups to begin with because I was playing a lot of Beatemups at that time. I was confused then as to like what was the channel name and what was the show name and what was more important. I didn't really know much about YouTube at that point, and the channel name didn't matter to me. It was what were we gonna call the show? What were people gonna know me as via the show? I had it completely backwards. So I was like, ah, Beatemups. I like Beatemups. YouTube at that time were like, you can't have that word. And I don't know, for whatever reason, I got rejected. So I was like, ah, well, I also like Beatemups, I guess. It wasn't even like, I don't like Beatemups that much. In fact, to this day, I've made it a point to not make a single video about Beatemups. And then I'm like, well, everyone's gonna know me as the Game Quest, right? Cause that's gonna stick. Name cannot be blank said, how are your knees today? Have you moisturized them? I wear jeans religiously. I do not wear shorts ever. So I couldn't even tell you what my knees look like. Probably very knee. The next person doesn't have a name. They're just kind of an emoticon that looks like this. And they asked, what was the worst video idea you ever went through with? And that's a fantastic question that I don't know if I have, I don't know if I have an answer for. There isn't a video on my channel that I look back at and I'm like, ah, I shouldn't have done that. Other than like just going back to the start and cringing at, you know, how there was no video that was like inherently a, well, okay. All right, there is one. Well, I talked about that show, The Game Quest, whatever, no one remembers it. After I stopped doing it, I didn't know what my channel was at that point. I still loved games, but you know, back at that point, my channel wasn't doing hot in general. It didn't matter if I put out games or whatever, like no one was really watching. So I didn't really feel like I had a footing anywhere. And I've always liked commentary channels, people that look at other channels that are doing ridiculous stuff and kind of calling out how ridiculous they are. Like H3 was one of my favorite channels for a long time. I mean, I still love their podcast. And then Comedy Shorts Gamer, he said he was gonna cut an Xbox in this video. It was like all clickbaited, like I cut an Xbox with a hot katana, and then I watched the video and he never did that. He just did a bunch of other things. It was just a cringy video to watch in general. Nothing on the guy. It's like one of his only videos I've seen because it was an Xbox. It was gaming related. I saw kind of like and in, I was like, maybe this is my chance, you know, I can use the Xbox side of it to kind of bring whatever fans I have right now into watching it, maybe I can be a commentary channel, and I just kind of laughed at how dumb his video was, and how silly he was acting in his video, and it was just, let's cut this Xbox in half! Yeah, I'm glad I didn't go down that avenue. It was just a really weird point in YouTube for me. It was like two videos, and yeah, I definitely do regret that. I can't do drama. I absorb the negativity and it just makes me sad.
Whoa, okay.
If you could play a game from your childhood again, as if it was the first time, Travis, this is something I think about all the time. I would love the ability to just erase blank my mind on a certain subject or thing or whatever, just in life in general. That would be so handy. But like with movies and books and video games, I would love to just be able to be like, yeah, I don't remember that anymore. I wouldn't want to do it with something like Ocarina of Time because the nostalgia I have for that game is what makes replaying it now so much better. But there is for sure games in general that I would like to replay not knowing what was gonna happen. Like, I have quite a bit of nostalgia for The Walking Dead as well, but replaying it, I never feel the same way about it as I did the first time. Sergeant Gnome, my voice broke. If you didn't do YouTube, what career path would you have taken? It's a really great question. Shout out to Vinny as well, by the way. I didn't want to see any of the questions you guys asked, so I asked Vinny again Ryan, the editor, get on board with this. Go watch his channel as well. Shout out to Dice Roll on YouTube. It's actually, he makes some pretty cool stuff. Go give him a sub. All right, what career path would I have taken? I've talked about this a bunch before on my channel, but before YouTube started, I really wasn't doing anything with my life. I worked in a retail store in a dead-end job that I absolutely hated, and I wasn't fulfilling my life at all. And I don't want to blame other people or blame my upbringing or anything like that, but it did crush me to the point where I just didn't care and I didn't want to do anything with my life, and I just accepted it was what it was. I could afford to buy video games. That's all I really cared about. So if I didn't ever start YouTube, if I never started it, I probably wouldn't be doing much right now. I wouldn't be me either, because YouTube has shifted and changed me for the better in so many ways. And then when I found Kim, she helped me become a better person and a better man. I did that show Game Quest. It was kind of like a reality show in a way, and I got to see the way I acted in front of people, and I was like, that's me? Like, what a kid. I was a kid when I started. I was a childish kid who never grew up because I didn't really get a chance to. If I was to stop doing YouTube now is a more fun question I'd like to answer. If YouTube just went like and it was gone tomorrow, all my videos were gone, everything was gone, at that point I would just become a video editor. I mean, I have this portfolio of how many, like 600 videos. What type of wood is your favorite, says Ark? Oak. Almost like two letters off your name. Why? I don't know. I like a good oak desk. It's just a strong, sturdy piece of timber. Reliable. So I like oak. It's a nice word too. If you could play one game for the rest of your life, asked Taylor, what game would it be? I can't stand that question. Whenever I do a panel, there's always that one person that asks, if you were stranded on a desert island, what game would you take and why? Because I'm like, do I pick a game I really love and then end up hating it? Or do I just take a game I hate because I already hate it? I'll just hate it more, but then I'm stuck on an island with a game I hate. In saying that, thank you for the question. David asked, when did you get into gaming? I mean, I've been into gaming as long as I can remember. I've said this before, so I'll keep it short. My parents had an NES at the time I was born. What? From as early as I can remember, I was playing Super Mario Bros. 3 and sucking at it, Menace Beach and sucking at it. Never had the original Zelda, which sucks. And then at some point around 10, I got a 64. My first game on that 64, and one of my only games, because I couldn't afford many, was Ocarina of Time. And that game is like the point where I was like, oh, video gaming is legit. Like, I like messing around on the NES and that's fun for me, but this is an experience. Tegan, how old were you when you met your girlfriend? Besides the Switch, what console do you use most? PlayStation? Honestly, at this point, probably Xbox. And I'm not saying I prefer Xbox when I say that, but the last PlayStation exclusive was what? Spider-Man? And because of Game Pass, I always have like free games to be playing. And I like the native 4K on Xbox, and I really like the Xbox Pro controller. I would say it's like 80% Switch, 15% Xbox, 5% PlayStation, until an exclusive comes out, and then it's like 100% PlayStation until I've beat it, and then I trickle back into my ways. Archer asks a very heavy question, considering I'm an hour into filming this and trying to wrap it up as quick as possible. What are the best and worst things about being a YouTuber? A question she should know the answer to, as she is one herself. The thing that I'm gonna say is best, and we're gonna get to that, there's no equal to it in worst, because the best thing is so up there and incredibly amazing, that feeling the opposite of it, I'm nowhere near it in the worst category, if you get what I'm trying to say. The worst things is just, I guess, the general pressure to always be doing something. Like, I work from home, a lot of us do, and so there's no separation between work and home life, so I'm always thinking about YouTube from the moment I wake up to the moment I go to bed. I always feel like I should be filming or editing or writing or doing something, and it's just like little things here and there, things people say, like going through like all this work and effort to bring this like quality product to the platform, and then you put it out there, and then just because you titled it in a way that upset people, it just gets disliked and you get all these hateful comments, and it's like you're always trying to balance a line between a catchy title and then, you know, something that's not considered clickbait. There's nothing like horribly bad about it, at least not where I'm at now. Like, I'm feeling really good about YouTube. I'm filming all the time. I'm always moving and working and doing something for the channel. And I guess that leads into like the best thing, which is obviously you guys. It might sound like a typical, I'm just saying that cringy, but no, it seriously is you guys, because I'm making this for you guys. And I think sometimes creators might forget that. I hope not. But ultimately, the only reason I'm doing any of this is for you. Like, I'm not doing this for me. I'm not putting this out there for me to watch later. I'm putting it out there hoping that you guys are gonna enjoy it and like it. Literally everything I do in my life is for you. And I think people lose sight of that, but I definitely haven't, and I definitely won't, because it's the only reason I do any of it. The reason why I want this video to go out to as many people as possible is to entertain as many people as possible. And if it wasn't for you guys watching it, I wouldn't be here doing it. All right, guys, this video was exhausting. Like, on it, for some reason, this was more exhausting than my normal videos. It took an hour. That sucks. Thanks for all the questions. I really appreciated them. I hope I gave somewhat good answers. I really don't know what I'm doing. Smash like on it. It really was just for you guys. Like, if you're watching this still right now and you don't know who I am, that's kind of weird, but subscribe. Thank you. I don't know. Bye.
Let's cut this Xbox.